Just handling them, and even under the wrong conditions, e-cigarettes can explode. Is swimming with sharks bad for your health? Probably. Today, we're gonna talk about vaping. You've heard it all over the news. Kids are dying from vaping? Hey everyone, I'm Dr. Wagner. I'm a board-certified real-life emergency medicine physician. On my show, I'm gonna answer all your emergent medical questions and clear up some myths about medical ailments. So what is vaping? Why has it become so popular lately? Is it safe? And is vaping better than regular cigarettes? And can vaping actually kill you? All great questions, and I'm gonna go over all of that, plus clear up some other myths about vaping. If you've turned on your TV lately, you've probably seen reports about people dying or having severe medical complications that have been allegedly related to vaping. As of September 2019, the Center of Disease Control, aka the CDC, is calling it an outbreak. There have been reportedly a whopping 530 cases of lung injury in 38 states, one US territory. So what is vaping? Vaping is slang for the act of inhaling and exhaling the aerosol or vapor that's produced by an electronic cigarette or vaping type device. According to the CDC website, e-cigarettes work by heating up the liquid to produce an aerosol that users can inhale into their lungs. The liquid, which contains sometimes nicotine, THC, and other additives. The term vape is used because e-cigarettes do not produce tobacco smoke, but rather an aerosol, often mistaken for water vapor. Aerosols are substances enclosed under high pressure that can be released as a fine spray, typically by a propellant of gas or oil, for instance, hairspray. What are the symptoms of vaping-related illnesses? In many of the cases, patients say that they experience trouble breathing, shortness of breath, and chest pain before they are brought to the hospital. Some people have also said that they've experienced stomach issues, including nausea, vomiting, and diarrhea. All right, who's at risk for vaping-related lung injuries and illnesses? People who vape are the ones at risk. Anything that you inhale into your lungs that is not air can potentially harm you. And I don't care if it tastes like strawberry shortcake, it still puts you at high risk. Why is vaping causing all of these injuries? Investigators have not yet identified a common brand, type of device, or drug across all cases. The only common thread? All patients have reported the use of e-cigarettes or vape. In other words, we don't know yet the exact component that is causing all of the drama. So are they dangerous for your health? Is swimming with sharks bad for your health? Probably. On a very basic level, just handling them and even under the wrong conditions, e-cigarettes can explode and cause serious injury. But recently discovered health risks range from exposure to toxic metals or e-liquids, which can cause seizures, brain injury, and heart attacks. So here's the big question. Can you die from vaping? Yes. At the time of the posting of this video, 8 deaths have been confirmed in 6 different states, with 16% of the deaths including children under the age of 18. If you're watching this later than I posted it, it's probably a lot more. How do you prevent vaping-related disease or injury? Easy. Don't do it. When it comes to your health, I would suggest minimizing every risk possible to injuring your lungs. You only have 2 of them. Whether you're inhaling heated vapor or aerosols with the e-cigarettes, or burning material and chemicals such as with regular cigarettes, the only way to prevent it is to stop it entirely. Are e-cigarettes and vaping healthier than regular cigarettes? Let's not get crazy here with the word healthier. Although some reports out there say that there are fewer toxins and cancer-causing substances in e-cigarettes than regular cigarettes, the truth is, vapes and e-cigarettes haven't been around long enough to know the true damage it causes us. Only time will tell which, if any, are less risky than the other. All right, that's been your 5 minutes on vaping with me, Dr. Wagner. I hope I've cleared up some of the myths regarding vaping out there and helped you get a better understanding of this potentially deadly outbreak. Make sure you leave a comment with whatever medical questions or topics you'd like me to make a video about, and make sure that you subscribe to the channel and turn on your bell notifications. That way you can learn when I post a new video. Thank you so much for watching. And stay healthy, my friends.